3D printing might be a buzz term, but at Pennsylvania College of Technology, it's old news. The additive manufacturing process has been part of the manufacturing curriculum for nearly a decade.
We want the students to learn how to use the equipment responsibly and actually know the care and feeding. So they work on it, I mean, they're working on it, they're driving the car. So instead of just looking at it from a distance in a showroom.
I don't feel like I'd understand these machines as well if I didn't have a hands-on experience.
Working with the machines gives me a good opportunity to see how everything's going to change in the next couple of years.
Gartner Incorporated, an IT research and advisory firm, projects that worldwide shipments of 3D printers will exceed 217,000 this year. That's a 100% jump over 2014.
There's no limit to the complexity. We can make parts that you cannot traditionally machine or cast, parts that are made in ways that traditional manufacturing techniques just simply couldn't accomplish. Or if they could, it'd be very expensive.
3D printers come in all sizes and can manufacture products in a variety of material, ranging from plastic to metal. Whether those products are whimsical, musical, or even edible, the additive manufacturing process is basically the same. Design software communicates with a 3D printer that employs a layering technique.
Each layer represents something you're going to lay down on top of the previous layer. And all these machines, in some fashion or another, start with that idea where the layers are sort of glued together and the ultimate end is a finished 3D object that's solid. We make things here in hours, perhaps days, that might take weeks or months in the open market situation.
It's like, all right, well, I'm just going to hit print. And all of a sudden, a couple hours later, you have your part, and it's just, it's an amazing feeling.
I really love working on these machines. It's great because we're in our degree, we're so used to CNC machines for, you know, subtraction machining. It was interesting working with machines because it gave me a different view and different perspective of how to look at manufacturing. You can kind of sit back and just watch your creation get made.
More than 100 students in manufacturing-related majors work with the college's 8 3D printers. According to Albert, that hands-on experience produces more than parts.
A number of our students are actually directly hired into a company because they can, in fact, either work in an already set-up environment or set up one themselves.
It really brought in a whole different layer to my resume.
I think it's going to really take off in the future. It'll make me very marketable to the world.
For PC Today, I'm Tom Speicher.